Jesus, we'll bless your name, Father. Oh Lord, we give you all the glory, we give you all the praise. Lord, we'll bless your name, oh Lord. Lord, we'll bless your name, oh Lord. Lord, we exalt you, we give you glory. We give you praise and glory. We exalt your majesty in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Quickly, I would like to read from Psalm 99. The Bible says, the Lord reigns. Let the people tread him. He seated between the cherubims. Let the head be moved. The Lord is great in Zion, and he is high above all the people. Let them praise thy great and terrible name, for it is holy. The king's strength also loveth judgment. Thou dost establish equity. Thou executed judgment and righteousness in Jacob. Exalt him, the Lord our God, and worship at his footstool, for he is holy. Moses and Aaron among his priests, and Samuel among them that call upon his name. They call upon the Lord, and he answered them. He spake unto them in the cloudy pillar. They kept his testimonies and the ordinance that he gave them. Thou answered them, O Lord our God, thou was a God that forgavest them, though thou tookest vengeance of their invention. Exalt the Lord our God, and worship at his holy name, for the Lord our God is holy. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Bible says the Lord reigns. Let the people tremble. He seated between the cherubims. Let the head be moved. The Lord is great in Zion. Our God is a great God. Our God is a mighty God. He's not a God that requires turmoil as his own sacrifice. But the sacrifice the Lord requires from you and I is our praise and our thanksgiving. Let us exalt the name of the Lord. Let us worship him. For the Lord is holy. He is great. He is a mighty God. King of all the kings, he is the Lord of all the lords, he is the mighty God, he is the ruler of all the earth. The Lord sits in heaven and makes the earth his footstool. Our God is mighty. Let us begin to worship him. Let us begin to praise his name. Let's worship our Lord and our God. Let's give him praise. It is the Lord who was, who is, and who is to come. He is the everlasting King of glory. Oh Lord, we exalt you, Father. Lord, we magnify you. Lord, we exalt you in the name of Jesus, for you reign in all the earth. Father, oh Lord, we give you praise, for you sit among the cherubims. Lord, we exalt you in the name of Jesus. Father, oh Lord, we give you praise, for the sea parted at the breath of your nose. You are the great and mighty God. You are the terrible man in battle. Lord, we worship you, we give you praise. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for going ahead of us in the name of Jesus, even unto this day and this month. Lord, we give you praise in the name of Jesus, for you have gone ahead of us even into year 2021. That's why we are still alive today, by your grace and your mercy. Lord, we exalt you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your mighty hands of protection over us, over our family, over the church of God, over our nation. Despite all various challenges, the Lord has kept us even in his pavilion. Lord, we give you praise, O Lord. We give you praise, O Lord. We magnify you, O Lord. We exalt you in the name of Jesus, for you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, we exalt you, Lord, we give you praise. If you have a million tongues, they are not enough, even to praise your holy name, for great and mighty things that the Lord has done unto us. Lord, we worship you, Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we worship you, Lord, we give you praise. We exalt you in the name of Jesus. We magnify your holy name in the name of Jesus. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. We exalt your name, our God. We worship you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you are the only King of Israel. Father, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, you are our Redeemer and our strength. Father, O Lord, we exalt you. Lord, we bless your name. Father, O Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we bless your name. We give you praise. We thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, for every time that we appeared unto before you. You give us answer of peace. You attend to our need and our situation. You turn things around in the name of Jesus, even for our own good in the name of Jesus. You perfect everything that concerns us, everything that concerns our family. Lord, we exalt you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your building us in the name of Jesus, even as your church. Lord, we exalt you, we give you praise. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for divine health in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your divine healing in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your power has gone forth in the name of Jesus, even able to heal everyone that is sick or that is with one infirmity or the other. Lord, we exalt you in the name of God. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We magnify your name, O Lord. We magnify your name, O Lord. We exalt you, we give you praise. We exalt you, we give you praise. We exalt you, we give you praise. We thank you, Lord, in the name of God, for the peace all around us. We appreciate you, O Lord, in the name of God, for your blessing that abound unto us. We give you all the praise, O Lord. We thank you, Lord, in the name of God, for meeting all our needs in the name of God. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your divine provision, for your divine protection. We give you all the praise, O Lord. We give you all the praise, O Lord. Father, O Lord, in the name of God, we come before you with thanksgiving in our heart. Lord, we come before you with thanksgiving in our heart. We exalt and magnify your name. We exalt and magnify your name. We say, be thou exalted forever, O Lord. Let us begin to thank the Lord on behalf of our ministers in this assembly, on behalf of our deacons and every level of leadership. Let us begin to bless the name of the Lord on behalf of every worker and every member. For the wisdom that the Lord has given unto us, for the grace and the spirit of unity that the Lord has bestowed upon us, that we are coming together, able to unite together as a believer. It is not because we are not perfect. It's not because we don't have our own various weaknesses, but it has pleased the Lord to keep us together in unity and in love. Let us begin to appreciate the name of the Lord. Let us begin to bless his name for his love that dwells among us, that for his love that has been shed abroad, even in our hearts, in the name of God. Lord, we exalt you, we give you glory. Lord, we exalt you, we give you glory. We praise your name, O Lord. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your servants in this house, in the name of God. We exalt you in the name of Jesus, for your grace upon them, in the name of God. We thank you, Lord, in the name of God, for you have kept them by your mighty power. Lord, we exalt you in the name of God, for all our deacons and their family. We thank you, Lord, in the name of God, for every HODs and their executive. We thank you, Lord, in the name of God, for every laborer in your vineyard. Lord, in the name of Jesus, it is a great privilege even to serve in your house. It is a great privilege even to be to become your servant. Lord, we exalt you, Lord, we magnify you. We do not take this for granted. It has pleased you, O Lord, in the name of Job, that you have made us laborers in your vineyard. Lord, we give you praise, O Lord. Lord, we give you praise, O Lord. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Job, for your grace that you have released upon us. We exalt you and magnify you. We exalt you and magnify you. Please now exalt us forever, O Lord. Lord, we worship you, Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we worship you, Lord, we give you praise. Jesus' name we are praying. In Jesus' name we are praying. We are going to go before the Lord this evening and surrender our hearts to you. We are going to say we are going to say we are going to ask God for his blessing upon us. I believe that the virtue of going through our day, interacting with people, one way or the other, we have done something that somebody that hurt someone, or someone has done something that hurt us, that give our heart, somehow it make our heart to be in a state that cannot be brought before the Lord. We are going to ask for the mercy of God, that by the reason of the blood of Jesus that was shed upon the cross of Calvary, that the Lord will cleanse our heart and Lord will deliver us. If you have any iniquity in your heart, it will be difficult for the word of God to come into our heart. The purpose for which God is sending that word. We are going to surrender our heart before the Lord, and we are going to cry for his mercy. The mercy of God has been better thing than the blood of Abel. We are going to ask that the Lord will forgive us our sin, every iniquity, every impurity in our heart, that the Lord will glorify us, that the Lord will purge us every unrighteousness in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord, our God, we render with you. We submit our hearts unto you this evening. We ask, O Lord, in the name of God, that you will purify our hearts, O Lord. You will purify our hearts, O Lord. You will sanctify our hearts, O Lord. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of God, by the reason of the blood of Jesus that was shed upon the cross of Calvary, that blood that cried for mercy, the blood that speaks life, the blood that speaks better things, even than the blood of Abel. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will use it for the remission of our sin. In the name of Jesus, every sin or every known sin, every unknown sin, in in the name of Jesus. You will cleanse us in the name of Jesus. Nothing shall hinder your flow in the name of Jesus. Even in our midst today in the name of Jesus. Nothing shall hinder your presence in the name of Jesus. Even in our midst today in the name of Jesus. There shall be divine encounter in the name of Jesus. For our hearts shall be open, O Lord, even to receive your word this evening. In the name of Jesus. Mantale kere poshinegrebo. Regede batone kere balegrebo. O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Purge us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Purify us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Sanctify us in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere poshinegrebo. Regede batone kere balegrebo. Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let every impurity in our hearts in the name of Jesus be removed in the name of Jesus. Let everything that choke the word of the Lord that is in our heart in the name of Jesus, let it be removed in the name of Jesus. Even at this moment in the name of Jesus, mantale kerebo, regede batone kerebo. In Jesus' name we are free. The Bible says, "Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty." That means the coming of the Spirit of the Lord at this point, that the Spirit of God will come and have His faith in our midst. That everything that we are going to do today shall be by the meaning of the Holy Spirit. That we do not out of our own understanding, we do not out of our own mental capacity, but we shall be led by the Spirit of God. That the Spirit of the Lord will fill this out. That everything and anything that is contrary to of God in this environment, let us begin to cast them out and let us begin to enthrone the Spirit of the living God even into this atmosphere in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere boshinegrebo, regede batone kere bababalegrebo, regede batone kere balegrebo, legede batone kere boshinegrebo, regede batone kere balegrebo, le mantale kere boshinegrebo, rogodo batone kere boshinegrebo, regede batone kere bababalegrebo, legede batone kere boshinegrebo, regede batone kere balegrebo, mantale kere boshinegrebo. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we ask, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, for the presence of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Let your Spirit, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, fill this atmosphere in the name of Jesus. Let your Spirit in the name of Jesus fill this house in the name of Jesus. O Lord, our God, in the name of Jesus, we invite the sweet Spirit divine in the name of Jesus even into this place in the name of Jesus. Let your glory descend in the name of Jesus upon this house in the name of Jesus. Let your glory descend in the name of Jesus upon this tabernacle in the name of Jesus. And everything, O Lord, in the name of Jesus that is contrary to the counsel of the Lord, Lord, we bind them and we cast them out in the name of Jesus. For you said in your word that every tree that is not planted by my Father in heaven shall be uprooted and thrown into the lake of fire. O Lord, in the name of Jesus, we uproot, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, every spirit of buying and selling, every spirit of distraction in the name of Jesus, every power from the feet of them that may want to shift our focus, even from the Lord that is seated upon the throne. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we chase them out in the name of Jesus. We said they have no place in this environment. In the name of Jesus, for your Spirit, O Lord, shall indwell us in the name of Jesus. Your Spirit, O Lord, shall indwell us in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere boshinegrebo, le mantale kere boshinegrebo, regede batone kere balegrebo, legede posnegrebo, le mantale kere boshinegrebo, regede batone kere babalegrebo, mantale kere boshinegrebo, legede pazone kere boshinegrebo, le mantale kere boshinegrebo, legede pazone kere boshinegrebo, le mantale kere boshinegrebo, legede pazone kere boshinegrebo, legede pazone kere balegrebo, mantale kere boshinegrebo, legede pazone kere boregrebo, legede pazone kere boshinegrebo, mantale kere boshinegrebo, legede babalegrebo, legede posnegrebo. Lord, in the name of Jesus, let your Spirit in the name of Jesus fill this atmosphere in the name of Jesus. Let your glory descend in the name of Jesus upon us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let your glory descend in the name of Jesus as the dew of heaven in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere boshinegrebo, regede batone kere boshinegrebo. O Lord, in the name of Jesus, we ask in the name of Jesus that you will clothe us with your glory and your beauty. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will beautify our life in the name of Jesus by the reason of your word in the name of Jesus, by the reason of your anointing in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will beautify our life in the name of Jesus. You will beautify our family in the name of Jesus. You will beautify the church of God in the name of Jesus. Mantale kerebo, regede baso negrebo, leket pos negrebo, le mantale kerebo, regede baba baba negrebo, lekete pos negrebo, regede baba baba negrebo, le mantale kerebo, lekete pos negrebo, lekete pazone kere posh negrebo, mantale kere posh negrebo, regede batone kere posh negrebo. In Jesus' name we are free. In Jesus' name we are free. We don't know those things. We don't know the situation that they have. That the Lord will comfort their heart, the Lord will wipe away everything that caused them to sin, everything that caused them to fall. That the Lord will remove it from the heart of all our members, of all our family members, and the Lord will give us joy. Peace will be our portion in the name of Jesus. Let us begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Father, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, O Lord, as our faces differ, so also our situation differ. Lord, we begin to pray, O Lord, for as many as have one pain or the other in their heart, for as many as have one thing or the other that make their heart pain, that make their heart to be sorrow. Lord, we pray, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, by the reason of your word, Lord, you shall wipe away every tear from their eyes, everyone that cries in the corner of their room, and they cannot come out and share those things that make them to be sorrow. Lord, we pray, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, for you will comfort them in the name of Jesus. You will bring comfort to their heart. You will cause them to rejoice, even in those situations, for you will come through for everyone in the name of Jesus. You will send forth your power in the name of Jesus. And your power, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, shall be at work, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the life of every member of this assembly. In the name of Jesus, your power, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, shall be at work in the name of Jesus, in every family in the name of Jesus. Father, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, we speak against, O Lord, every form of disunity in our various homes in the name of Jesus. We speak against every form of discomfort in our various homes in the name of Jesus. Whatever the challenges may be, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will come through for everyone in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will come through for everyone in the name of Jesus. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you shall comfort those that mourn in Zion in the name of Jesus. Lord, you shall comfort those that mourn in Zion in the name of Jesus. Mantale kerebo, regede baba ba legrebo. Legede patone kerebo shlegrebo. Regede patone kerebo shlegrebo. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will wipe away all tears in the name of Jesus. You will wipe away all tears in the name of Jesus. There shall be no more pain in the name of Jesus. There shall be no more death in the name of Jesus. There shall be no more sorrow in the name of Jesus. There shall be no more crying in the name of Jesus. Father, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will comfort every one of us in the name of Jesus. Father, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will begin to do a new things in the name of Jesus. For former things have passed away in the name of Jesus. And you will begin to do new things in our lives in the name of Jesus. For this is our year of newness in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we are praying. And the verse 5 of that scripture says, and he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for this word are true and faithful. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. One of the assurance that we have is that for every word the Lord has spoken unto us, we are certain and we are sure that the Lord will bring it to pass. And I pray that nothing, no situation able to hinder the promise of God in our life of coming to the fullness in Jesus' name. You are good going to be praying according to that verse 5. And he said, and he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. Hallelujah. You are going to be praying. This is our year of newness. I don't know the kind of, from weeks ago, Pastor was sharing about new glory, another level of glory. But the Lord will begin to do new things in our life. Probably we are at the rough bottom. Lord is so powerful that he can take us from mighty day and take our feet upon the rock. That's what our God is capable of doing. We are going to be asking God. The Lord will begin to do new things in our lives, in our family, in this church, and in every department. That we begin to see new glory. We begin to see God moving in a new dimension, in a new realm, in our life and in our situation. Let us begin to pray. For the Lord has promised new name for us. Let us begin to declare that the Lord will begin to make all things new for us. No matter the level of achievement that we might have had in time past, that the Lord will begin to do new things in our life in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere poshlegrebo, regede batone kere babalegrebo, mantale kere poshlegrebo, regede batone kere balegrebo. Oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, we ask, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your newness in our lives in the name of Jesus. We ask, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your newness in our lives in the name of Jesus. Even as the word will be coming forth, oh Lord, Lord, in the name of Jesus, your word will come to us in the name of Jesus, even afresh like never before. For our hearts, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, are opened unto you in the name of Jesus. Lord, you begin to move in a new way. You begin to move in a new dimension in the name of Jesus. You will release your new grace upon us. Fresh grace, fresh anointing in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere poshlegrebo, regede batone kere poshlegrebo, remantale kere poshlegrebo, regede batone kere poshlegrebo, regede pazone kere babalegrebo, remantale kere poshlegrebo, regede batone kere poshlegrebo, lokoto pazone kere poshlegrebo. You begin to make new ways for us in the name of Jesus. Father, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, you begin to do new things in our lives in the name of Jesus. You begin to do new things in the name of Jesus, even in this assembly in the name of Jesus. We shall see your glory in the name of Jesus, like never before in the name of Jesus. For your glory and your grace in the name of Jesus is released upon us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Mantale kerebo, legerebo legrebo, mantale kerebo, legerebo legrebo, legete pos legrebo, le mantale kerebo, mantale kerebo. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you shall make all things new for us in the name of Jesus. You shall make all things new for us in the name of Jesus. Mantale kerebo legrebo, legerebo legrebo, legrebo, legete pos legrebo. In Jesus' name we are free. In Jesus' name we are free. Lord, we ask, oh Lord, we declare in the name of Jesus that you will begin to do new things in the name of Jesus. Father, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, you begin to do new things in our lives in the name of Jesus. You will make a way for us in the name of Jesus where there seems to be no way in the name of Jesus. By your mighty power, oh Lord, that you use in parting the Red Sea in those days, Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will cause every door that has been shut against us to be opened in their own accord in the name of Jesus. As you come through for Peter in the prison in those days, so shall you come through for us in the name of Jesus. In every situation in the name of Jesus, for us in the name of Jesus. Your angels, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, shall go ahead of us in the name of Jesus. Your angels, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, shall go ahead of us in the name of Jesus. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will make every crooked way straight for us in the name of Jesus. And you will put it, oh Lord, every rough edges in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere bosh negrebo, regede batone kere balegrebo, re mantale kere bosh negrebo, regede batone kere bosh negrebo, regede batone grebo, mantale grebo, regede baba baba negrebo, regede bosh negrebo, regede batone kere bosh negrebo. In Jesus' name we are free. In Jesus' name we are free. And finally, we are going to ask you God, and that as you go on in this service, that we don't miss God. Hallelujah. One thing that I have that I've come to understand is that it's not just enough for one to like say, okay, I'm coming for Bible study, and at the end of the day, when you look back, you discover that you are unable to get anything out of that service. And that's because the devil is so smart that he has a way of distracting us in the course of the service. That even when God is saying one particular thing because of the situation that we have, we will not be able to pay attention. We are going to be committing ourselves until the end of God. That as I go on in this service, I will not miss God's presence. I will not miss the divine presence of God. Even in this service, as the word will be coming from, as the praise and worship will be coming forth, that every word that the Lord has for me, everything that the Lord has said Jesus. I ask, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, I will not miss you in this service, in the name of Jesus. I will not be distracted, in the name of Jesus. Nothing shall hinder me, oh Lord, from entering into the Holy of Holy, even in this season, in the name of Jesus. As I have come to appear before you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, you shall take me into the Holy of Holy, in the name of Jesus. I shall commune with you, even in the course of this service. I shall have a smooth fellowship with you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. That which you have proposed to do, even in my life and in my situation, in this season, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, I will not miss out on that, in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere posh negrebo, legede basode kere balegrebo, legede basode kere posh negrebo. In Jesus' name we are faith. And let us commit the servant of God that the Lord is going to be using this evening into the hands of God. That the grace of God will be multiplied unto you. That fresh anointing, able to speak the word that the Lord has prepared for us, even in this hour. That the grace of God will be released unto you. That every counsel of the enemy, every attack from the feet of hell, will stand against them in the name of Jesus. We cover him with the blood of Jesus. And no power from the feet of hell will be able to hinder the flow of the Spirit of God, even in this service, in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere poshi negrebo. Regede batole kere bababa negrebo. Mantale kere poshi negrebo. Oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, we know that your word is already anointed. Father, oh Lord, we now pray, oh Lord, that your servant will commit unto your holy hand. Lord, we ask, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for fresh anointing, fresh grace, in the name of Jesus, upon him, in the name of Jesus, even as a minister, oh Lord, we commit him unto your holy hand, that he shall minister by the power of your name, in the name of Jesus. He shall minister by your spirit, in the name of Jesus. He will not deliver the message by his own understanding, but Lord, in the name of Jesus, you shall fill him afresh, in the name of Jesus. You shall fill him afresh, in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere poshi negrebo. Regede batole kere poshi negrebo. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we stand against every work of the darkness, even in this environment now, in the name of Jesus, for your light and your glory is upon this house, in the name of Jesus, and your light and your glory is upon this altar, in the name of Jesus. Father, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, you will cause your power to flow, even through your word, even through the praise and worship, even through the prayer, in the name of Jesus, even by our interaction, in the name of Jesus, there shall be manifold presence of, there shall be manifestation of your presence, in the name of Jesus, and you will glorify yourself, oh Lord. Mantale kere poshi negrebo. Regede batole kere bababa negrebo. Regede batole kere poshi negrebo. Le mantale kere poshi negrebo. Regede batole kere poshi negrebo. Legede batole kere balegrebo. Legede batole kere poshi negrebo. Lord, we ask, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for fresh grace, in the name of Jesus, upon your servant, in the name of Jesus. We ask, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your mighty presence, in the name of Jesus, in the praise and worship, in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will glorify yourself, in the name of Jesus. Your spirit will move, in the name of Jesus. Mantale kere baba balegrebo. Regede batole kere poshi negrebo. Regede batole kere baba balegrebo. Mantale kere poshi negrebo. Regede batole kere balegrebo. Lord, we bless you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We give you praise, oh Lord. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for this first session of prayer. We thank you, Lord, for everything we have asked. We believe that we will receive answer of peace, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we bless you, Lord. We give you praise. For in Jesus' name, oh Lord, we are praying.
Come on up here, mountain, and shout. your hands together for Jesus. If you know you have a promise in him, hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come and put those hands together for the Lord Jesus. If you know you are ready to praise the Lord, come and celebrate him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I will exalt you, Lord, for thou hast lifted me above my enemies. Your banner over me is low. Hallelujah.
I will exalt you, Lord.
I will exalt you, Lord.
You have lifted me above my enemies. Your banner over me is low.
Come on, your hands together to the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Hallelujah. Above my enemies, your banner over me is low. Hallelujah.
I will exalt you, Lord.
I will exalt you, Lord.
You have lifted me.
You have lifted me.
Above my enemies. Hey. Your banner over me.
Your hands together for the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Amen. I will lift up your name.
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 I will lift up your name. I will lift up your name.
Above every other name.
I will give you all the glory.
Your name above every other name.
Say, I will lift up your name.
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 Hey, I will lift up your name.
Above every other name.
Big, big God, mighty God, Jesus Christ, you don't know. Speak me God.
Speak me God, mighty God. Jesus Christ is the mighty God.
Come on, put your hands together for the big, 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 big God. Amen. Big, big God, mighty God. Jesus Christ is the mighty God. Hallelujah.
Big, big,
big, big, big,
big,
big God.
Jesus Christ.
He's a big,
big God.
Big, big God.
Big,
big God. He's a big,
big God.
Big, big God.
Big,
big God.
Jesus Christ is Almighty God.
Unquestionable, you are the Lord. Unquestionable, you are the Lord. Unquestionable. Unquestionable, unquestionable, you are the Lord, you are the Lord.
Unquestionable, you are the Lord.
You are the unquestionable Lord.
Unquestionable, you are the Lord.
You are.
Unquestionable, unquestionable,
you are.
Unquestionable, you are the Lord.
Unquestionable,
God. Unquestionable, you are the Lord.
You are the holy living God, hallelujah.
Unquestionable, you are the Lord.
You are.
Unquestionable, you are the Lord.
Have you all seen what God, you are the living God.
You are the living God.
There is no one like you. Your dance offering to the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Ekueme. If you know the Lord is good, come on, give him all the praise. Give him all the praise. If you know the Lord is good to you, hey, despite the situation, the Lord is still good. He is good in our circumstances. Come on, give him the praise. Thank you, Jesus. Do my to the Lord of Lords. Oh yeah, mara, 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 mara. Mara sot, mara sosi. Hey! I cannot see you dancing. Dance to the Lord of Lords. Dance, give him your dance offering. Hallelujah. Dance to the King of Kings. Hey, bami rababa, foba ogo. Oh, yeah. You want me? the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Rose of Sharon. Give God a praise. Give him the praise because he's Yahweh. Give him the praise. He's Yahweh.
Worship God, the Lord of Lords, the
the King of Kings, Emmanuel. I am that I am, the mighty man in battle, the mighty man in battle. Abba, Abba. Oh, we want in one label. Worship God, worship God. Lord, we bless you. We bless you tonight. We bless you tonight. We bless you, oh Lord. 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 Lift Jesus higher. Lift Jesus higher. Lift him higher. Lift him higher. Lift him higher. Lord, we bless you.
Oh, It's a declaration. It's a song of victory. And so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Shall we be seated? God bless you. I may apologize for our traffic delays. Amen. I started speaking, and I would like to just go straight into where we stopped. Started speaking on the subject of achieving transformation, particularly in this month of our transformation, the month of April. And I believe that the most important thing, according to the Word of God, is not to be hearers of the Word, but the doers of the same. So it's not just to know it's my month of transformation. It's not just enough to know that God desires that we lead transformed lives. It's not just to know the meaning of what transformation is. What is important is that you and I experience a transformation. Say to somebody, you will experience a transformation. And we took our text from the book of Chronicles, 1 Chronicles chapter 4, reading the story of Jabez from verse 9 to 10. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge my coast, and that thy hand might be with me, and that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God granted him that which he requested. May the Lord grant the request of our hearts in the name of Jesus. Shall we pray? Holy Spirit of God, we receive your engrafted word to save our souls, to heal, to deliver, to make whole. Holy Spirit of God, breathe upon the letters of your word, breathe upon the hearts of your people, and let there be an indelible mark of change. Let there be a glorious transformation that we might become whom we have ordained in the name of Jesus. We depend forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And I spoke to us generally about what transformation is, but that more importantly is for you and I to target achieving it. And I shared with us about two or three points on achieving transformation and what it will demand from us. First thing is that it demands that we renew our minds, and in the process of renewing your mind, you will need to begin to ask yourself questions you probably didn't used to ask yourself, criticizing your normal thinking stream. Why is this like this, and why am I going to continue like this? Why should my situation be like that? Those were the questions that Jabez asked himself, seeing this situation he found himself, that triggered the hunger, the conviction to demand for something different from whatever it was that he previously experienced. I also said, in renewing your mind, you must have a firm conviction to stand on the word of God no matter what. The second point we discussed on achieving transformation is that it will lead a man to the place of being dissatisfied with his current experience. And then the third was to deepen your understanding and your capacity. But I'd like to just take off from there quickly. The fourth thing for those who pray, desire, and long for transformation in their lives is that you must learn from your past errors. You cannot experience the transforming power of God if you refuse to learn and rise above past mistakes, past omissions, past errors, things that ought not to have been, the failings of the past. You cannot keep repeating those same errors, yet expect a transformation, yet expect that there will be a difference. That was why when Joshua realized that they defeated Jericho, but the next city defeated them, and he went to God straight away and said, what have we done wrong? Why did he seek to know? Because he realized that this is not the expectations that we had. This was not the results. This was not the fulfillment of your promise. So what went wrong? And in the process of that,
God told him that there is sin in your camp. You have a curse and a curse thing in your midst. And until that is taken away, Israel will not be able to stand before his enemies. And Joshua had to take the time and the pain to gather the people and began to sort out by lot, began to sort out till they narrowed down the fault to the household of Achan. And by the time they narrowed down the fault to the household of Achan, who took the accursed robe and all of the wedge of gold that he buried in his tent from the kingdom of Jericho that they were not supposed to take. When they removed that curse, they went again to face the same town that defeated them, and this time they overcame. Hallelujah. You can hardly have achieved a transformation if you are not going to look back and cure the wrong errors. If you made a mistake, it is not wrong for you to go back if it's just to say sorry that will cure it. Sometimes people keep backing the wrong horse, keep backing a dead horse, keep flogging a dead horse, and they still want it to be transformed. They still want to accomplish change. They want to keep doing the same thing and hope that somewhere in the future it will still lead to a positive outcome. You are not ready to reform. You are not ready to change. You are not ready to try. It's not going to happen. That's the same problem you have in political structures. You want better results, but you are not willing to transform and change from your past errors. I was reading somebody's post today, some political friend who posted something and sent it to me, and he said that when Lagbaja was president, these were all his or her ministers. And then when Pamedo was president, these were all his own ministers. And then weighed it side by side with the incumbent and said, so what are you complaining about? I was so irritated by it that so, and I had to respond, and I said, so, because the crude mentality has persisted, so you must justify it. We are saying if something is wrong, it is wrong. Whether it was performed by your brother or performed by somebody else's brother, does that make it right? So you can see his mentality is that we will continue to carry it on like that, depending on who is on the throne at any given time. And yet you won't change. And yet you want to see a transformation. For as long as you are not going to correct that wrong-mindedness and that way of thinking and that way of operations, then you cannot achieve transformation no matter who is king. No matter who is king. If you are going to apply the same erroneous ways of the past, then it does not matter who is king. You can fight you tomorrow and say it has to be A, it has to be B, C, or D. If it is still going to be in the same way that they used to do it, that you also do your own, what is the difference? And that's what some people want. They want transformation, but they themselves cannot learn and move away from their past errors. Move away. Jacob accomplished a lot of things by deceit. He won his brother's birthright. He got his brother's blessing. So you can say that he also gained some ground by virtue of his lifestyle. But a season came in his life that he realized that this will not get me far. He realized that for as long as this is my way of doing things, for as long as this is my approach to doing things, for as long as this is the strategy I'm going to continue to execute, I will not see change. And then when he was returning from Laban and he wanted to correct whatever losses, whatever wrongs he had done with his brother, that was his primary goal. Before he was even going to look for where to settle down, where he would put his head, where he would lay his family, his primary goal was to first rectify the error of his past with his brother Esau. That was his first target. Because he realized that I cannot become anything that I hope to become if this sword is still hanging over my head. That's why he sought his brother out. And he did all he could to placate him until he realized that the brother was not even after him anymore. It was only after that that he now went to find a place to lay his head. Now went to find a place to plant his family, plant his household. Do you understand what I'm saying? But many people don't want to learn and move away from the past, move away from the errors, the mistakes, the omissions, the deception, the fraud, and all of that of the past. You want to build a mansion on the fraudulent earnings of the past. When Zacchaeus met Jesus, and Jesus said, "This day I'm going to spend at your house." And while at dinner in his house, and having listened to the word of God that changed him, he said he not only believed, but that he was going to rectify the errors of his past. He said, "Anybody that might have unlawfully taken money from, I'm going to restore him fourfold." He was willing to start anew, start afresh. Many people want transformation, but they don't want to start like that. They still want to continue and still just want to ignore and behave as if, well, it doesn't really matter. You can just carry on. Everything will meet themselves in front. And that's why transformation continues to elude men, elude families, elude nations. For as long as they pray it, for as long as they believe it, for as long as they desire it, they will not achieve it, no matter how much they wish for it. Until you begin to move away from those things. That's why the Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things must do what? Pass away. All things must pass away. You cannot carry the old things along with the newness that you have just received. Said all things pass away and all things become new. Not just figuratively speaking, but reality speaking, all things must pass away. Praise the Lord. Number five, you can hardly achieve that transformed life if you learned nothing from your past missteps or misdeeds. Number five, be ready to try something new. One of the critical things about living a transformed life is that it is a new thing. It is a new life. It is a new experience. It is a new encounter. In some cases, it is so novel that you yourself, you are still wondering, how am I going to navigate it? Yet, you are ready to challenge yourself. Transformation comes to people who are willing to try something new, something totally different from what they were familiar with. When Jesus called Simon Peter and Andrew and he said to them in Matthew 4, "Follow me and I will make you fishers of men," they were not trained in the school that Jesus was asking them to follow into. At least not yet. But they were willing to forgo whatever they were doing to try something new. They were willing to let go of where they were coming from so that they could become fishers of men. The transformational ministry that the disciples of Jesus experienced haven't just been ordinary fishermen, ordinary tax collector, ordinary whatever they were doing before. To become the kind of person the apostles of faith was clearly made possible by their ready conviction to try something new. That was why when they saw them in Acts chapter 4, after they had just healed the guy by the beautiful gate of the temple, and they said to themselves concerning these ones, that this conviction that these people have is different from every other one we have seen. These are unlearned and ignorant men. They must have been transformed. They must have received something. They took knowledge that they had been with Jesus. They could not have become like this if they did not start anew. If they were just still like fishermen that they were, they could not have been so transformed. Are you willing to try something new? You cannot just say transformation, you want to pray for transformation, yet you're willing to try something new in your life, in your ministry. Try something new. You know, the Englishman will say, you cannot make an omelette without breaking an egg. So if an egg wants to retain itself in its shell, yet wants to be transformed, how is it ever going to happen without being broken? If you want to become an omelette, the egg will break. And then there is transformation achieved. You cannot make that sort of connection, make that sort of change, achieve that sort of experience without trying something new. Transformation means you are moving from whatever form you are to become another form. You are moving from whatever state to another state of existence, a higher life existence. To be transformed means that it is going from a stage or state of existence to something totally different. There are many things that get transformed in the course of manufacturing processes. You bring out yam from the farm as a tuber. While you are at the farm, you can decide you want to eat it like that. So you smoke it or roast it and you eat it in its tuber form. Or you can carry it home and turn it into yam flour and make amala out of it. Or you can boil it and pound it and turn it into pounded yam. Or you can slice it and make it into yam chips. Or you can change it into as many forms as possible. But do you know that whatever it is that you know about every raw material that you use today is just limited to what you know? Some other person will come tomorrow and be ready to try something new. If you thought it was only Gary that can come out of cassava, that's the limit of your enjoyment of the returns of your cassava farm. But the person that realizes you can turn this cassava into ethanol, which is of a higher value, he will get more value by that transforming process than you that you're only turning your cassava into Gary. Do you understand what I'm saying? Something new. There is always something new. Ideas never dry up in the bosom of God. Anyone desirous of transformation must be ready for a new thing. One young boy came into my office today, and he was wearing a t-shirt, something robotics, this, that, artificial intelligence. And I thought maybe he was just, I wear a t-shirt that says I'm president of the United States. It doesn't mean I am. So that was how I thought his t-shirt was. But when I started asking him questions, he said he was going back to work. I said, so where are you working? He said, this is where I'm working. And I pointed at what he was wearing. I said, where is that work? He described this. I said, I've seen that signboard somewhere before. He said, yes, I saw it, but I just thought typically people just like highfalutin sounding, where they just call themselves, space technology company limited. You are not, it's the only space you know is this space, I just imagined like that. But when he told me, I just said, are they really? He said they are, that he's actually been in the school since September. And that they do this, that they are now creating drone technology. I said, that's very interesting to know. Now, what I'm simply saying is that whoever set it up decided to try something new. He said they are creating drone technology for the purpose of courier delivery, so that they won't be carrying Okada to my office to come and serve DHL or UPS. It will come to the office by drone technology. It exists in other countries already, but they are doing their own here. You may not know, I didn't know until I spoke with the guy. But the day you know is when somebody calls you on the phone and says, look out your window, you have a package. And you looked out your window and it is just a drone that is hanging there to come in and deliver your package. Hallelujah. Try something new. Look at your body, try something new. You cannot be praying for transformation and you are afraid to take some new steps. You are afraid to break out of your comfort zone. You are afraid to challenge the status quo. You are afraid to take a leap, to take a launch into the future that is still relatively unknown. There is always something new that you can try. And those who have ever broken through with inventions in the world space of intellectual capital are those who dare to do something new. All the inventions and patents that exist are products of the newness that other people generated, even from existing infrastructure or existing state of the art. The only meaning of the patent letters that people register against inventions is to register your addition to the status quo. That's what patent is. Hardly will you find, except in some very rare occasions, hardly will you find a completely, totally brand new device. It is usually an improvement of the existing device. And so, maybe before they made this microphone, there was a microphone. Those are Uja. that you have to do 12 before you know whether it is even working. You know those ones. But over time, they made it with superior material. Then they started making multi-directional microphones. Then the microphones got smaller. Then they made the ones you can hang on your waist and just hang on your neck. And it is more powerful than the big ones that we hold. Do you understand what I'm saying? They were improving on the state of affairs as it was. You started with your Nokia 3310. Then they did 3210. They did 6060s. They did 88 that. They did communicator. They did all of that. Then you moved to BlackBerry. Then they went to smartphone. It is still phone. But it still started from the phone that was invented by Graham Bell. Do you understand what I'm saying? Graham Bell was the inventor of the telephone, rotary dial. That was still the original technology. So if you check the patent records over the centuries or over the decades, you will see the patent records from Graham Bell all the way down to whoever invented the most or the latest version of input or application that makes a phone become a phone. That's what patent. So there is always something new. That's why you see very cool manufacturers, every year there's a new one. Every year there's a new one. Every year there's a new one. And some things that we never thought was possible has become possible. After a while, they said they are making camera for food, for cars. So the car can see the back, can see the front. Then later they started making, for new cars, 360-degree camera. So while you're inside the car, you can see front, you can see back, you can see side, you can see everything inside the car. Without you looking back or looking inside and all of that, it is somebody's improvement. Now, I was reading one editorial online recently about a new Mercedes that they just made or maybe about to make. And they said that one can not only just see your front, see your back, it can tell you if you are driving out of church, it can tell you there is traffic at Bodija Junction. You are not yet there, but it can already tell you that there is a traffic, and this is not Google Maps. That is something new. And that is what is transforming nations of the world. Intellectual capital. Not resources under the ground that the African countries are still dependent on. Transformation. Economies of the world have been transformed because they dare to do a new thing. Because they decided to try a new thing. Because they put themselves in a position to move out of the existing status quo to something higher than they had ever experienced. Praise the Lord. When nations and individuals are afraid of new things, are afraid to try the new, they begin to decay. Can you imagine if we are still getting electricity by coal in 2021? If electricity is still purely coal. But we move from coal to hydroelectricity. Then we move from hydro to thermal. Then they move to gas. Then they move to solar. Then they did nuclear. And it is getting to different heights. That's what it means to be transformed. And so the nations that used to thrive based on the exportation of coal for coal-fired plants all over the world, they would have gone ahead of other nations in the days when coal was the required standard. They would have been the richest nations of the world, isn't it? But when the technology changed to become oil, the oil nations begin to make more money than the coal nations. Praise the Lord. But when gas became the driving force, then those who didn't have so much oil but they had gas, they started to make as much money as well. Now that we are migrating to solar, oil will no longer have many. And so everybody is clearing out, hey, Nigeria, the only thing you produce is oil. Nobody will need your oil in a few years from now. You better find another place to make money from. And that's why you are hearing all that narration. Because once they can do without oil, nations that used to pride themselves as the largest oil producer, largest oil this, largest oil that, it will cease to matter because nobody will be buying it except you want to drink it yourself. Amen. Even vehicle manufacturers are giving themselves targets. BMW says by 2050 all their cars will be electric power. All. So anybody who is buying BMW as official car must recognize that to continue to use it, you must be able to charge it like you charge your phone. And that's how nations plan. That is transformation. Be ready to try something new. And so God will inspire in your hearts new thoughts, new ideas. New ideas about the same business. New ideas about the same enterprise. Or totally new ideas that have not been done anywhere. Because he's a God of newness. And to accomplish newness, you must enter into the realm of being transformed. And it starts, like I said, with renewing your mind and all those other points I gave you earlier. If you don't start with that, it will be difficult for you to think of anything new coming out of it. You will speak like those that said, can any good thing come out of Nazareth? Because they are only looking at Nazareth between within the prism of who or what they knew of Nazareth of old. Just like some can be telling you today, can any good thing come out of Nigeria? Tell them to just watch. Hallelujah. Just tell them to watch. It might take a while, but it will surely happen. And like I always say to you, it will happen in my generation. That this nation will be transformed, not in the generation of my children, in my own generation. I will see it like this. Praise the Lord. And we must believe it. Number six. Sometimes achieving transformation can come out of your negative experiences. Achieving transformation can come out of your challenges. It can be the trigger towards your transformation. It is not every negative experience that must produce negative outcomes. It is not every negative experience that leads to a negative outcome. Achieving transformation may be dependent on how you handle and relate with or in that contrary experience that you might be currently going through. Don't think that a disappointment is all, and that's all, is all the beginning and the end of it. A disappointment can become an appointment with destiny. Don't think that a delay is all that it has to offer. A delay can create a stepping stone for a rising. Don't think that a job loss is all it has to offer. For that job loss can positively transform you if you handle it well. Don't think that a sudden calamity is a crash. Job had sudden calamities. But what he became at the end of the sudden calamities was much more than what he was before the calamity. Don't think that because I have suffered a loss, suffered a disadvantage, suffered some kind of problem, in the course of the challenge of walking through life. Don't think that that ends it. Daddy died when I was younger, so I stopped education. Don't think that is the end of it. Don't think that that is the reason why you cannot move forward. Don't think that is your bus, that is your bus stop, or that is your end of the road. That in itself can become the instrument of transformation. I will always share the testimony of a family that is very dear to us. Our family friends, we all grew up, went to same primary school with me, went to the same secondary school. There were four boys, one girl. The four boys and I, we all went to the same secondary school. One was my brother's classmate, another one ahead of me, the other two were my juniors. But we're all very friendly. Our parents were friends and all of that. And we grew up, went to UI, we went to Ife, and all of that. We got out of school. Two were still in university. Two were just out of university when their father died. Three were still in the university. And then their father died. It was so devastating to their mother. It took a while. Within 2 weeks, they did the burial of the dad. And then the mother had to travel with a family relation somewhere in the east just to calm down. And while she was there, she developed a complication. They had to schedule her for a surgery, and then she died. Within 1 month of her husband's death, the mother died. It was such a tragedy. Such a tragedy. And I remember we were talking sometime at home, and I was saying, how are these people going to? What's going to happen to them? Guess what? When the Bible says, when mother and father forsake me, I will lift you up. That was exactly what God did. Two of the uncles just said, don't worry, we'll finish your education. They had a brother that was still working somewhere. He had a job. Another one, the second one, got a job. They got a job for him at Chevron. Two came out of university. Both of them went into Chevron. Today, as we speak, their last born had become executive director but in a Kwekwe Awero and Sons Limited, in a conglomerate, became an executive director in UAC. Their last born, who was still in secondary school when all this happened. The other two ones had, one is now even just appointed the MD of a major oil producing company. They are all oil guys. But when you look back at the time when the tragedy struck, there was nothing that looked like opportunity for them. But everybody that was around them that realized that, so it's just these 5 children on their own. Even the brother had not even married. Nobody was married. Today they are all married with children. Blessed with every blessing you can imagine. So sometimes a negative experience, it might be negative now, but it can accomplish and produce transformation in the future. They sacked you from your job, and you are still brooding and crying every day because they sacked you from your job. Come on, shake that away and ask God for the next step towards your transformation. If you remain at that job, maybe it will not give you the opportunity for that transformation. But now, you are being freed to fly. Sometimes we have those negative experiences and sudden calamities, delay in admission. You didn't get admission first time. You didn't get admission second time. You didn't get admission third time. And you're about to give up. So let me just go and plan a trade. Me too, I didn't get admission first time. I didn't get admission second time. Okay, I got admission second time, but they offered me something that was not in my dream. To come and do sociology in University of Ilorin. And I will never forget what my father said to me. And he said to me, he said, it's better to lose this year and go and do the job again and get in for the law that you have always wanted to. Than for you to enter university by force. And after 4 years, they are still wondering what exactly you are going to do with it. Because you have no vision for it. It was painful. Because all your classmates are in the university. Everybody had gone ahead of you. You went to upper six. Praise the Lord. But I roughed it and did the exam again. And entered for law today. Is that not just story? Even those that went from Form 5 and read law, they have not achieved what I've achieved with the law in the same profession. So why would I now be thinking of what am I going to be thinking of? That's how God works. He can turn that negative experience to positive. That's what you call the loss. It can become a gain. What you thought was a loss, it can become a blessing. It becomes a testimony. That was what Joseph told his brothers in Genesis 45. He told them that everything you meant for evil, God turned it round for good. Everything you thought was, even Joseph at that time was begging his brothers, don't do this. Please, you are my brothers, you are my blood. Please, don't do this. Because at that time, it seemed like a loss. But in Genesis 45, he said to them, reading from verse 5, "Now therefore be not grieved nor angry with yourselves that you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life. For these 2 years the famine has been in the land, and there are 5 more years when there will be no earing nor harvest. For God sent me before you to preserve you a posterity in the earth and to save your lives by a great deliverance. So now it was not you that sent me here, but God. And he hath made me a father to Pharaoh and Lord over all his house and a ruler throughout all the land of Egypt." You meant it for evil, but God turned it around for good. There are many things the enemy meant for evil. There are many things the enemy might orchestrate or plan in our lives and want to trigger for evil. But the Lord will turn it around for good in the name of Jesus. Many delays that we might have suffered, God will turn it around for good. Whether it's delay in admission, delay in marriage, delay in childbirth, delay in getting a job, whatever it is, God will turn it around for good in the name of Jesus. Achieving transformation can come from your negative experiences. But when a person drowns himself because of the fact that he has suffered a negative experience, he has suffered a negative encounter, and he drowns himself in the sorrow of it, he cannot see the spark of light, the ray of hope, the glory that is yet to behold. It was a negative experience for Jesus to have been crucified, but that crucifixion led to the resurrection. Without that crucifixion, there would have been no resurrection, there would have been no salvation, there would have been no deliverance, there would have been no glory. But that crucifixion had to happen. That's why the Bible says, if the devil had known, he would not have crucified the Lord of glory. It was better not to have allowed that negative experience to have happened. But since the devil thought it was gaining something by allowing it, God turned it around for a greater glory. The transformation of the entire world came by virtue of that singular negative experience. There are many things people suffer negatively for. There are many losses we might have encountered, but God can turn it around for our good. God can change it totally for us. Sometimes when I look at nations, I look at authorities, I look at individuals who gain power and use it recklessly against others, I ask them and I ask myself, have these people read in the Bible? Before your own nation came, there were nations before you, bigger and stronger and mightier. So any nation that is exerting force, influence, power, authority, and throwing its weight all over the world today, you go back to the Bible and read the stories of nations before it. The territories the nations of today command is nothing compared to the territories that the nations of old commanded. The entire Africa was just divided into just a little bit of maybe about 10 empires. Today you have 54 countries. But in those days, it were just about 10 empires controlling the entire what you call 54 countries. So you can imagine the power and the authority of those nations. At that time, there was no Asia. Egypt's influence was beyond Africa, up to Asia, up to Europe. The Persian kingdom, their influence stretched all the way to Asia, stretched all the way to Africa, stretched all over Europe. The Ottoman Empire of Turkey stretched all the way to Africa. Today, they are just Turkey. So whatever control you have today as a nation is nothing we have not seen before. There's nothing you have today that people didn't command before. Even when you claim you're a nuclear powerhouse today, before nuclear weapons came, there were nations that had their own special equipment and special machinery for war before nuclear power came. Yet, in spite of what they thought they had, a day came, a season came, a time came that were defeated. Nations had defenses that were impenetrable, but God brought down the walls of Jericho. So anything you see today that anybody is glorying over, it had been done before. And nothing is new. that's why we need to understand that any experience you encounter in the course of life, God can turn it around. God can turn it how? Around. I've worked for people, worked for companies that I was a hero on the throne as MD of the company and didn't want to see my face, felt to whatever reason, for whatever purpose, was just very, you know, negative towards us. After a while, I didn't quarrel with him. I just gave him space. And then I didn't know, what I was out of the country when I heard that he had been deported. They just removed him. And he was deported. And then they brought another Pharaoh there. And while I was away, the new Pharaoh started calling, looking for all those who had worked for them. And they gave him a number and they called. And that was how everything got changed. Now imagine if at the time when I was going through negative experience, you responded in like manner. You two, you want to be there, and you will not be able to go back and rectify. Hallelujah. There are many things that happen. There was a time a company was owing us for work done for 5 years. Can you imagine having finished the job for 5 years and they don't pay you? And you write letter, write letter, write letter, have meeting, and all of that. And other people who work for them wrote them stinkers, some even sued them, and all of that. Each time I wanted to do the same, I had a check. Then one day I got a phone call and they invited us to a meeting in Abuja. So we went, had the meeting with them. They had this very serious matter that was going to kill them. And they wanted to brief us to take it up. So I said, what of all this outstanding? I said, don't worry, we'll pay the outstanding and we'll pay this one. And immediately they started the payment of the outstanding. So what happened was the people they would have used had already bloodyfooled them and gone off. Ordinarily, that sort of job would not have come to us. But the people that, the big men and big women that were already there, they had already walked off, stormed out of the party. So they were stuck with us. So if it was meant for evil, God turned it around for good. Negative experiences can lead to transformation. And that's the reason why, even when somebody tries to despise you, Jesus said, pray for them. Those who despise you, persecute you in any form, pray for them. You don't need to give them back in their own coin, because a time will come when things will turn around. The king that sits on the throne today and considers himself or herself as untouchable can come back to your door to ask for a privilege and ask for a favor. But you would have to trust God. You will have to believe God, that God is the one who can turn things around. But if you allow the immediate emotions of today in your current experience to drown you, you will not see the miracle that is about to happen. You will not see the transformation that particular experience can bring you to achieve. The death of the husband of the widow in 2 Kings chapter 4 was what led to the transformation of the finances of that entire family. When the man was alive, for lack of revelation, he was in debt. For lack of revelation, he was borrowing to meet everything. And he finally died, and he did not pay his debt, and the creditor came to carry the two sons to become slaves. You will walk off your father's debt. But the woman went to the prophet of God and said, my husband just died. He was a pastor like you. And now the creditor has come to enslave my two sons. What will I do? The man said, what do you have in your house? I have nothing. I said, he died in debt. What will I have? If I had, would I not have sold them and paid? I only have one little oil in a cruse. That's the secret of the miracle. And with that little oil in a cruse, the transformational miracle that God did in their lives, the prophet of God said to her at the end of the miracle, he said, go sell the oil, pay your debt, and live on the rest. The rest was so enormous that she could live on for the rest of her lives. Having paid her debts. But it came out of the demise, a position of sorrow, a place of loss, a place where she would have been crying and saying, if my husband were here now, would this person... No, it came out of that experience. And she received a transformation out of it. Never think the negative experiences you go through is the end of the road. It can be a stepping stone to achieving your own transformation. Let's rise, lift our hands, and just for a moment or two, I want you to just commit yourself to God. You are not just here to hear the word, but to become the doer, to become like the word that you have heard, to become like the word that you have just received, to become like him whom the Lord has commanded of you, achieving newness. Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, to become like you, to become whom you have commanded us to be, to become whom you have declared us to be. We can do nothing of our own self, but we can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens us. We can do all things through Christ Jesus, who has called us out of darkness into his light, who has brought us into his marvelous light. Pray and commit yourself to God. Whatever area might have been limiting your own transformation, maybe you keep repeating the same errors of the past. Maybe you cannot dare trust God for something new. Ask the Holy Spirit for an impartation of grace, the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of knowledge, the spirit of counsel and might, the fear of God, the spirit of boldness, the spirit of courage, to be able to stand firm in the face of every opposition, in the face of every negative experience. Lord, that you will turn it around for our good, that as a nation you will turn around our current afflictions to the miracle of your deliverance. In the name of Jesus, let the Egyptians we see today depart from us. Let the terrors that we experience today depart from us as a people. In the name of Jesus, let your power, Lord, be manifest upon our land, be manifest upon the hearts of our leaders, upon the institutions of our country, upon the streets of our land. In the name of Jesus, Lord, turn around our captivity, turn around our captivity, and turn it around for good in the name of Jesus. Spirit of a living God, let our testimony be like that of Joseph, that every instrument, every conspiracy lifted up against our land for evil, turn it around for our good in the name of Jesus. Every weapon of oppression deployed against this nation in any form, in any manner, Lord, turn it around for our good in the name of Jesus. Every instrument of evil that the enemy had thought to use against the peace, against the well-being, the economy of our country, Lord, turn it around for our good in the name of Jesus. Let our lives become a testimony, an inspiration amongst men. Father, we give you praise. Lift your hands, bless the Lord, just give him thanks, just give him praise, just glorify the name of Jesus. We honor and we worship you, O God. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Can you say a better amen? Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's be seated as we bring out our offerings.
next on Sunday, we're gonna be sharing ministry on starting like a finance seminar series this Sunday. And I say this seriously because I believe one of the new things that you and I desire of the Lord is that the Holy Spirit should open our eyes to new heights that we can accomplish, new thoughts, new ideas. And so I believe that this is one instrument that God is going to use to transform lives, to impact lives, and to turn our situations around as we walk into this year of newness. I want to encourage you to make sure you share the flyers, invite your friends, invite family, and make sure you're part of the service. Again, let me also remind particularly our parents that our children's church is as we open. So in case you have been coming without the children, or you know those who have not come because the children didn't have the children's church back yet, let them know that the children's church is back on stream, physically meeting now. Meanwhile, please let's continue to observe the protocols as advised. Praise the Lord. Shall we rise? As we close, Father, we want to thank you. We honor, we praise your name. We bless you forevermore for your grace that is always sufficient for us. We appreciate you, Lord, for the transforming power of your Spirit in our lives. Holy Spirit, turn around our circumstances. Turn around our captivities. Turn around our situation for good in the name of Jesus. We give you praise forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Look at somebody and say, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life as you dwell in the house of the Lord.